So guys, here we are with Everyday, and Everyday is a habit tracker. I do like to explore my habit trackers recently. You may have seen the Habitify review. I am also planning to do a Habit Trackers of 2019 feature, so do stay tuned for that one, and do subscribe if you're brand new to this channel. So here we are, Everyday Habit Tracker is very simple. This is the web version. It's also available on iOS and Android, and it does have browser extensions. Now, just to give you a bit of a background, I first explored this one on Product Hunt. I then looked into it, downloaded it, got started, and it's really a very visual habit tracker, allowing you to very simply add like a habit and keep track of them. Like, there's not really much to it, but what's quite nice about it, what makes it special, is that you can actually view it in this sort of plot out mode. So you can actually see like a running tally of which ones you've done in the whole months behind, and obviously you can look ahead. You can also keep track with some really simple progress bars, and there are a couple of other things as well that you can do with this application. So we'll be looking into this. We'll be looking at the web version, just to give you an outline of what's available, so you can manage it through the web version anytime. You can add and manage your habits on the go using the iOS, which has an iPhone and iPad, as well as an Android application. Now, it is available on browser too, so you can see there's browser extensions, and you can download it for Chrome and Firefox. And merely what that does is you can create, when you open a new tab, it appears automatically here. So if you're looking for something that allows you to keep track of it, or like be able to see it every single day without fail, then this sort of tab extension is going to be really easy, and it obviously appears in the top right hand corner. So it's very early days. Developers are indie developers from Barcelona. You can see their contact details down here, and you can actually reach out to them if you have any problems. To start with, it gives you a 30-day free trial, and then it's $12 a year, which I don't think is breaking the bank for a habit tracker, especially if you get on with this type of visual habit. So here we go. Let's have a look at what it actually can do. So you can see here I've put in go for a run, 5 kilometers, and weekly review, which doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to be a weekly one. This is more, I would say, designed for daily habits. So let's go ahead and create a new habit. Let's say I want to journal every morning, which I have been trying to do a lot more recently. I can go to the advanced options and actually have a break habit. So for example, the color scale will be descending when you break the habit, and no weekends. So you can actually set this up to appear on weekends. So I'm actually going to journal on weekends. So I'm going to click add habit. Now you can see here that the weekend option is now available. On the previous ones, I actually set the weekend to be off. So it does have the ability to have that. So very simply, you can start adding them. So for example, I actually got my journal last Friday, finally came in the post. So I'm going to tick that one. You can see here that it appears as a green, a lovely green here. And you can naturally ticker them off. I didn't do Sunday, but I did Monday. So you can start to see that I've got this nice indication as I'm going through. So if I press skip, it actually comes half unmarked. So I actually have the ability to skip a day as well. But if I want to tally it as one, I can do. So it's got sort of like skip days and also non-skip days. So you can backtrack if you want. You can go back to any days and actually find them. So down here as well. So for example, let's say on Tuesday, I actually did do my journal that day. You can see I did a 5 kilometer run and a journal entry. So I get two markers here. So you can see that, application. You can see here that today's highlighted, but over here you've got this quite nice way of seeing what your streak's working on. So for example, your current streak in each area, for example, this is the streak of 2, and the total count so far, 1, 2, 3, 4, is there. Now the magic is you can sort of 12 this slightly forward, and you can see the week count, the month count, and the year count. So if you're able to keep this going across the year, then you can be able to see that really nicely. So as you can see here, you can also scroll along and actually see a percentage of how much you've completed. So it gives you a really good indication of how well you're doing. Now, in terms of our progress tracking as well, you've got up here, you can see a total marked count of how you see stuff, which is very cool. So What I quite like about this application, I'd say its killer feature is definitely the ability to see, for example, you want to visualize all of your habits in one place and actually get a nice progress bar of how are you doing in terms of streaks. Getting that information all down, imagine if you had like 10 or 15 of them down here, it would be really good. Now there are some customizable areas. So for example, in settings, if I go over to my account, I can obviously have email reminders. So if I want to turn on a daily reminder, I can, and that will nudge me to add in my feature, my habit. I got a weekly reminder as well. I can turn that off. I actually have that one on. And also a don't skip twice reminder. So for example, if I receive an email, if I don't add a habit 2 days in a row. And the good thing is you can backtrack. So as you can see, here are a few of the micro additions. You can actually add a color to it. And they've got a few color ranges at the moment. You can go back in and edit. And also if you want to scroll back some of the previous days, you can and even modify those. So it's a good way in being able to keep track of all of your habits prior as well, if you want to be able to backlog some of the ones you've already done. And the great thing is you've got this nice indication up here to see how well you're doing in terms of total marked habits. So guys, that all in all is the application. A few of my final thoughts on this one. It is very simple, but it's a great application if you're someone that really relies on a visual habit tracker. And if you're looking for one that sticks to you like every single day in terms of the new tab on Chrome, it's gonna work well for you. Now, I think it lacks the progress insight necessarily that the likes of Habitify and Strides includes in the habit tracker. The pricing is fairly acceptable. $12 per year is pretty reasonable, and again, you're supporting a independent developer too, and what I quite like about it is chances are they're going to be adding a lot more abilities to this soon. Now, just to give you an idea of other pricing, Strides is free for up to 7 habits you have. It's $5 per month after that, so if you want to add more than that. If you want to use Habitify, it's 3 habits, and then you're stuck. Whereas when you pay the $12 per year, you're accessing unlimited habits, which is very useful. So guys, let me know in the comments what you think of this one. Just before we go, I'd like to thank Sanebox for sponsoring this video. You can check out Sanebox. Sanebox is an email management solution. I use it every single day as a way to manage my inbox, and it really does help to reduce clutter. So you can check that one out, get $25 discount. Please do check it out because it's one of the recommended resources. It's January's sponsor, and I really do appreciate them coming on and supporting the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Anyway guys, if you're brand new here, do hit subscribe. If you would like to learn more all about our courses, feel free to go to our YouTube page and find everything there. Anyway guys, thank you so much. Let me know what you think of every day, and I will see you guys in another video. Cheers.